repair and build tissues, act as enzymes, aids the immune system, and serves as hormones. Examples of proteins in your diet are like seafood, eggs, and beans. Here's a fact. The population of first world countries are becoming increasingly obese. Being obese is the condition of being overweight. Things we can do to prevent obesity is to exercise regularly. You need 150 to 300 minutes of activity a week. To prevent weight gain, you need to eat like whole grain foods, such as brown rice or whole wheat bread. Malnutrition is not just eating enough, it's not also not eating any of the right things.
So there are different kinds of fats. Some are healthy, some are considered very unhealthy. And a common characteristic of the good fats is they will tend to be by themselves at room temperature in the liquid state. And for example, avocados and eggs are some of the good fats, while margarine and hydrogenated oils are the bad fats.
Over 25 million Americans live in food deserts. Food deserts are rural areas that are 10 miles or more from a supermarket. In order for us to like prevent food deserts, I think you could like make more supermarkets in those places so people have access to the fresh foods. Americans six and plus consume 14% daily calories from added sugar. Added sugars are sugars and syrups that are added to foods and beverages. They're not natural sugars, which are found in milk or fruits. Examples of foods and drinks that contain added sugar are like candy, cakes, juices, pop, cookies, candy. Eating a lot of added sugar can increase the risk of heart disease.
In 2008, an estimate of 49.1 million people experience food insecurity.
Food insecurity is when a person is unable to obtain the necessary amount of healthy foods on a daily basis.
All right, so our first concept is some of the mental health effects of proper nutrition as well as like malnutrition. So when you eat sugar, it's a simple sugars especially, they'll get broken down really quickly, and the serotonin will be released into your bloodstream, which is a neurotransmitter, causing you to feel hyper. But later on, that can lead to sugar crash, and overconsumption can lead to more bad things, such as obesity, which can have more effect on your mental health. Lack of proper nutrients, more than anything, it can turn into a bad habit. You'll feel unmotivated due to not having the proper energy. You'll feel sad because, again, you won't have the right energy, and you'll be low functioning. And obesity leads to more, it's a vicious cycle, and due to you having like a bad self-image, and you can feel stressed, depression, overall it just leads to worse things down the line. So, nutrition on ability to focus. There's a reason why you're told to get a good breakfast before like big exams, ACT and SAT. That's because when you're waking up in the morning, you need those carbs, that protein, to function well, and with proper nutrition, that can aid your cognitive functions and help you function at your best. So, caffeine. It is a psychoactive drug. It is the most commonly sold, distributed, used psychoactive drug in the whole world. It stimulates your central nervous system and causes you to feel hyper. You can get it in different forms, such as coffee, energy drinks, and slightly less commonly, you can get caffeine pills. It is rare, but you can overdose on caffeine. The most common problem is likely that students will try to substitute their caffeine for, like, okay, I need to study late, I will drink this energy drink instead of 2 hours of sleep, I have to study. But sleep cannot be so simply substituted. And if you try to, it can cause like long-term mental and physical health effects that will affect you even greatly, more greatly, when you're older.
So for our second concept, we have physical health. And eating the right amount of foods is essential for having great physical, mental health. right amounts of food can really affect your physical health. You can have heart conditions, high cholesterol, diabetes, a chance of stroke and cancer, and it can all be caused by just having the incorrect nutrition. Being active and having the correct nutrition has improved mood, and it can make you have more strength in bones, joints, and muscles. Fast food is our third concept, and America is projected to spend $223 billion by 2020 on just fast food. And fast food is absolutely not good for you. It has no nutritional value. It's full of carbs, sugar, unhealthy fats, and other bad stuff for you. In your diet, when fast food replaces nutritional food, it can lead to obesity, and the carbs usually break down to sugars.